Hi, I'm Kevin Ford. Today on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV, we're with Todd Masson, Marshman Masson on YouTube, on a great morning in South Louisiana. We're going to do something a little different today. Catching speckled trout? Yeah, we do that all the time. We're going to catch some and some nice ones. And we're also going to switch gears and do some bass fishing all in the same area, all here in St. Bernard Parish in South Louisiana. And you're going to see it right here on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV. LOA TV is brought to you by Ralph Sellers, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram in Gonzales, Louisiana's number one Ram dealer.
Ooh, there's a fish.
Got a fish.
Yep. Not as big as the last, Kevin.
Hey, a fish is a fish.
But I think he is a keeper.
Yeah, he definitely is a keeper. Pretty fish, buddy.
There he is.
Well, I guess we could say we are out here today out of St. Bernard Parish and fishing the Mr. Go, which is real close to New Orleans. In fact, you probably see the skyline in the back. The MRGO is a great place to come in the wintertime and fish for speckled trout along these rocks. Todd Masson, Marshman Masson on YouTube out here with us today. And Todd, this is one of your favorite things to do, I know.
Yeah, how can it not be, Kevin? I mean, it's just so productive out here. You've got deep water, really deep water in the middle of the MRGO. It almost always stays clean in here. It takes a really, really bad blow to dirty this place up. And so these fish, they just retreat to this deep water, move up onto these rocks to feed every day, and it can just be really, really productive in here.
Which you normally want, we have water temperature around 60 degrees. You normally want kind of some cloud cover so it doesn't get too warm on you. And it looks like we have a little bit of cloud cover. If that stays, could be good.
It could be very good. Could last at least a couple hours, maybe 3 hours, 4 hours, who knows. We could catch a whole lot of fish today. We'll see.
Hey, you're gonna have to watch and see what we catch, but it's gonna be a lot of fun. How could it not be fun on a day so pretty
Beautiful.
As it is out here? It's in January, temperature about 58 degrees. Doesn't get any better. Oh, there we go.
There we go, Kevin. Kevin, that's a nice fish.
Yes, indeed. Fishing with a softine. You and I are throwing the same colors, but
yeah,
just kind
no
of
doubt.
A different bait. You've got a lip bait, and I've just got a straight up softine.
Yeah, it's a mirror lip, and this bait's really productive. So is that one though. Ooh, he's barely hooked, Kevin.
No problem. There we go. Right into your living room. And hey, buddy, that's the one thing about coming out here. You have a chance to catch some really nice trout this time of year. A lot of times, wintertime speckled trout aren't that big. You know, you catch 12, 14 inch fish, but you can catch 3-4 pound fish on these rocks, and that's a solid fish right there. And
that fish is upward of 2 pounds. And literally, I've caught him 5 pounds out here, and that's a big trout for South Louisiana now. Five pound trout, you'll take that any day.
But that's pretty speckled trout right there, and that is the softine magic bait. And I didn't realize we both tied on the same colors, but this is actually a really good color combination you like out here, these bright colors.
Yeah, definitely. In this clean water, you would think you needed muted colors, but that's not the case. These bright colors work really, really well out here.
All right, let's get another one. Gosh, what a nice start. Now you book it pretty
there
good.
He
you got
there
it? He came back and hit it?
There he is. There he is. All right, Kevin, not as big as the one you just caught, but he is a definite keeper.
Does it matter?
I mean,
really.
In January? No, you'll take this every single day. You know, most people across the country are complaining about the cold, how miserable it is. And here we are, it's gonna be 74 today, and we're catching speckled trout.
Yeah, I mean, who can complain?
On a flat, calm day, is it getting any better?
Who can complain about this? Now, one thing I notice as you're going down the rocks here is you're moving at a pretty good clip. I mean, you're not, when we catch a fish, you're not slowing down. You just keep on trucking.
Yeah, there's no reason to slow down. You just gotta cover some water. These fish are spread out along these rocks. They're not concentrated at
okay.
all. Yeah.
Because a lot of times when you go fishing and you catch a couple of fish in a spot, you kind of slow and fish that spot, but these fish are just kind of all over these rocks. And I mean, it's endless amount of rocks up here. So just kind of keep on trucking this time of year.
Absolutely. Good advice.
All right.
I'm going to take it.
That's good. I'm going to see if I can get me one now. The last time I caught one, I was able to do it while you were putting one in the ice chest. Let's see if I can pull that stunt again.
That fish bit multiple times. Either he did or his buddies did.
Make sure to book your next fishing trip with a member of the Louisiana Charter Boat Association. Just go to lasaltwater.com.
Two things. I think it probably pulls a lot of them out, but I think it also makes the baits.
There we go.
There we go. There we go, Kevin.
Nice fish.
On that softine.
Yep. So you were
saying. Such a good bait.
We were talking about the sun just now as I hooked this fish, and a lot of times sun's not a bad thing, but sun in this situation can be a bad thing.
Yeah, I think it helps the fish to see the baits. They just don't look as natural. Also, I think a lot of those fish pull off these rocks when that sun comes up and they get kind of on this ledge. You can still catch them, but you want to throw a jigged soft plastic rather than these twitch baits. You're kind of fishing over their heads for the most part.
Now, even when it's colder than this, is it the same situation?
Colder is better, to be honest.
Yeah, right. So the sun doesn't have play that bigger?
Is correct.
The sun a bigger
That's a
factor when it's?
On a warm day like today, the sun's a very big factor. If water temp was 50 to 52, 50 is a little cold, maybe 52, 53, it would be, I mean, you could catch them all day. Even, you know, clear bluebird day, you catch them all day. Now, I'll tell you this, I do prefer clouds no matter what. Any right. temperature, I prefer the clouds. And if you don't have clouds, you want to have wind, and we don't have either today.
Hey, but you know what? We got some of these.
So we do.
Nothing to complain about.
I'm not complaining at
I'm
all,
I'm having
Kevin.
A great time.
This is just such a fun way to catch them.
It is. It's not the way you're going to go out and catch 150 fish by 8 o'clock in the morning, but it sure as heck is fun to get out here, and especially when they aggressively hit the baits, Todd. That's what I like. I like when they, a lot of time with these baits right here, you know when you get a bite. In the wintertime, you fish in a jig a lot. It feels like you have the bottom. This is almost like a summertime bite, as aggressive as these fish
get. Yeah, these fish are angry. They hit angry. They try and rip the rod out of your hands. There's no doubt when you get a bite. Now, there are some days where they swat at it. You might hook them in the back or in the side. Ooh, oh, missed him. But most of the time, like today, they will just annihilate it. And you can tell that's going on when they have the front hook. That's a good sign. When they only got the back hook, that means they're not real aggressive. Today, they are aggressive, at least for a time. We'll see what happens once that sun gets up.
It's funny how you can tell sometimes how you hook a fish the way they're biting.
Yeah, you're exactly right. That's definitely true with these baits. Oh, he hit it again. Hit it twice, come on.
As we're talking about how aggressively they're hooking themselves.
That one did not hit aggressively. He swatted at it. Oh, there he is. There he is. Oh, that's a good fish.
Kidding, buddy. That is a good fish, huh?
He hasn't come up at all, but man, that first tug was pretty good. Now he's feeling not quite as big.
That's a nice fish though, whatever. Yeah, well,
he's not bad. He's barely hooked though.
You got him.
Well, I had him.
It's like, I tell you, this is so much fun. There's so many ways to catch fish, but this is a unique way to catch them, going down rocks like this, Todd. And how long is this gonna last now?
It's gonna last until it gets consistently warm. Water temperatures in the 60s and they don't go back down into the 50s. I'm gonna say typically the end of February. It depends on how mild it is.
Right. But basically, if you had to pick your day, you'd want water temperatures in the mid to upper 50s?
I'm gonna say 52 to 55 would be ideal.
52 to 55 degree water temperatures, cloudy and...
Cloudy and a little bit of wind.
Yeah,
I don't want a lot of wind. I don't want, you know, 15 plus, but maybe about 8, maybe even 10. So it kind of ruffles that surface and it makes those baits not quite as visible. There he is.
Another one?
Yep.
Jeez, Pete.
That's a better fish, Kevin.
You like fishing over here. Oh, whoops. Yeah, it is. It's a great fish, buddy.
He came off.
That's a real nice one right there.
You're just jealous.
I've caught a limit of those today. Just like that one. You know, Todd, you fish a lot of the times when you fish, this is the area that you fish in and around St. Bernard Parish and the Mr. Go, and you go down to the Shell Beach area. Why? What is it about, of all the places you can fish, why do you always seem to come back here?
Because you can always find something that's biting. If the trout are not going to cooperate, no problem. I'll go run into the marsh and catch bass and reds. If they don't want to play, I can probably find some place, a big bay or an open lake, and drift a shoreline with corks and catch speckled trout. No matter what the weather conditions are, now I'm talking this time of year, in the winter, stretching from late fall through the winter and early spring, you can always, in any condition, find feeding fish. It's a guarantee. Now, the big mistake people make is they come out here and just kind of sit. They just kind of wait for the fish to turn on. No, that's like the bad strategy. You don't want to do that. Just keep moving and moving and moving. Cover water because you will eventually find feeding fish. It's just, I can't say it's a guarantee. I'm not going to say I've never had a bad day, but they're really, really rare. This area is just so incredibly productive.
LOA TV is brought to you by Soft Science Supreme Comfort Footwear, the most comfortable footwear you will ever wear.
There he is.
Oh, you got one?
Yep.
All right, Todd, we've shifted gears, my friend, and what do we have?
A nice marsh bass, Kevin. This is about as big as these fish get in here. They don't get to be massive. You're not going to catch what you catch at Toledo Bend or anything like that. We catch them up to 4.5 pounds, but a 4.5 pound fish is a rarity. Most of them are this size or a little bit less.
So let's give you a reset. Last time you saw us, we're catching speckled trout, and we knew that bite was going to be a short-lived bite, so we decided to come in this marsh, and all in St. Bernard Parish, St. Tammany Parish, but mostly St. Bernard back here. All of this marshland we've got, it's got full of bass, full of redfish, and it's a 12-month fishery, and Todd loves to come back here. I'm throwing a spinnerbait. You got a worm that you're fishing bouncing off the bottom, and these are nice little marsh bass, and there's plenty of them to catch. So we're gonna see if we can finish our day like we started, with a flurry of fish, this time going from speckled trout to bass. And Todd, where else but Louisiana can you do that?
In the exact same water, no doubt. I love this place.
Great place, and we'll see what we do. Although I hit that same spot 5 different times.
There he is. There he is. Oh, look how pretty that is. That's my favorite.
All right, so.
Slick, calm day, they jump out like that. Oh, it's so exciting.
You're fishing the worm, I'm fishing the spinnerbait, and it's no contest right now. Besides the fact that you think you're better than me.
Kevin, I know I'm better than you.
No, I mean, that's, let me get out of your way. One of us has to go one way or the other here.
So Kevin keeps calling us a worm. It's actually a Z-craw. It's a black light color, which you wouldn't think to fish in these pretty marsh waters, but I gotta tell you, it just works. I can't explain it. You would think you should throw something watermelon or whatever, and I do a lot, but this bait produces fish. It has become my absolute favorite. Now this one's chewed up. He's about to be retired, but this is just such an excellent bait.
All right, well, I think I'm gonna try one of those excellent baits.
Yeah, good, I'll give you one.
All right.
For a price.
How the Pros Do It is brought to you by Demco, your Touchtone Energy Cooperative.
All right, so Kevin's a good saltwater fisherman. He's not much of a freshwater fisherman, so I'm gonna rig for him. So what we got here is a 1/4 ounce bullet weight tied to a 4/0 extra wide gap hook. I tie an improved clinch, palomar'll work, whatever your favorite knot is. I'm gonna tie it really poorly so Kevin will lose his first fish. Okay, this is a Zoom Z-Craw, Z-Craw Junior, actually. And man, this bait, it just, I think it mimics a crab. That's what a lot of these fish feed on. You've got these two claw imitations. I don't know if they even know what it is. They just like it, I can tell you. And this black light is just the color. I love it.
Oh, there we go.
All right, Kevin. Bass.
See, I knew it was just a bait.
Oh, it's a redfish.
It's a redfish.
Little red.
We talked about that. Yeah, he did. But that's what we talked about. The great thing about these canals is you've got bass and you've got redfish in them. And you know, it's funny when you feel this water, how cool it is compared to how the air temperature today, which is about 70 degrees or so. But that's a pretty little redfish, and we're going to put him back.
Kevin, I was impressed with your hook set.
I was scared to death.
Pretty good.
I kind of felt more. Oh, ah, it's a bump.
There we go, Kevin. All right.
Another red. The redfish are here.
Kevin, we're bass fishing, buddy.
Well?
Bass.
Sometimes you can't take the salt out of the saltwater guy. All right, I'm supposed to be catching bass, but I'm catching redfish. But that's the great thing about fishing down here in St. Bernard and South Louisiana. You don't know what the heck you're gonna catch. And to me, it's all fun. Yeah, I got him that time.
Got him. Oh, Kevin, your first bass.
Got him. Boy, that thing hit like two or three times.
There
Boy,
you
he
go,
annihilated.
Kevin.
There we go.
That's why we came.
That's exactly why we came. Look at that. Redfish and bass all within 2 feet of each other. And you can do this all year round, which is so much fun. And the other thing about St. Bernard Parish that makes it such a great fishery is that it's so close to New Orleans. So you can come down here and you're basically 30 minutes from the French Quarter, wherever you are. So it's a great place to fish. I need to get this, put some pliers and get this fish off. Nope, I got him. And that'll taste good for dinner. Nice little marsh bass. Todd, I like your bait.
Yeah, no doubt. The only bad thing is, Kevin, we only got one more, and I'm going to fist fight you for it.
You can have it. You can have it. It's not that much. It's just not that, you know. If it was a speckled trout bait or something like that, you know, the salt water.
We'd brawl.
We'd brawl, but yeah, you can have it.
There he is.
Got him?
There he is.
Boy, in this deep, in the middle of the water, and you were saying.
Look at that. Look at that. It's another bass.
And you were talking about these bass being in the middle like this, it's like it's a winter bite.
It is, and you know, this water's warm, it's in the 60s, I'm really surprised, but they are definitely pulled out on these ledges. When we came in here initially, we were throwing along these grass beds and didn't give any bites. And I worked it down one ledge and got a fish, did it again, got another fish, and then we've kind of figured out the pattern. That's just how it is. Every day, yeah. You gotta figure them out again.
LOATV is brought to you by Ralph Sellers, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram in Gonzales, Louisiana's number one Ram dealer.
There we go. There he is.
Well, ooh,
oh, nice bass.
And that's the other thing, Todd, that you said about these fish. Once you get on these fish, they kind of school up. And Joey and I were talking about this yesterday. You don't think as bass of as a schooling fish. Like if you're a largemouth bass fisherman in a lake somewhere, you don't think of them like as a schooling fish. But these fish seem like they're, when you start catching them, there's a whole pile of them in one spot.
So I think in this marsh, there are certain areas that are really bait rich or have a lot of structure or something like that. And so they all kind of congregate there. I don't know if they're necessarily schooling, kind of like speckled trout moving through the marsh in a school. But they just tend to congregate in areas that are productive for them, that are producing bait and holding structure, that type of thing. Because, you know, look, we've sat here and pulled how many fish? Maybe 8 or 10 just off this one little area. Obviously, there's something here that these fish want to be holding to.
Right. And it doesn't look much different from areas that we've gone over where we didn't catch any fish.
Correct. Mm-hmm. Yep, that's why you just got to cover water.
And Todd said something a little while ago about this type of fishing. If you don't want to fish, if all you want to do is just come out and catch, this is not for you.
This is
because
not for you.
This is, it takes, what did we fish, 30 minutes before we caught one? Maybe
yeah.
25, 30 minutes before we caught a fish. So it's not like we just pulled right up here and started catching fish. You've got to cover a lot of area until you find these
you
things.
You've got to cover water, you do. And that's, you know, that's what I said. Most people, like, everybody likes to catch fish. Even non-anglers like to catch fish.
Right.
Not everybody likes to fish. I like to fish. I like to go and hunt and find areas that are productive. I'll go 2-3 hours without catching anything. For the potential of finding that mother load. I just love it.
Well, this is a lot of fun. All right, we'll let you get back at it. It looks like your bait's in bad shape too,
yeah,
and
I
have my eye
it
on
is.
The last one we have. All right, look, but I'll do this for you. I'll bend over.
All right, thank you, buddy. Oh, God. Outtake. There he is.
I knew you'd have one right there.
And cartwheeling
in. It's cartwheeling in. Well, Todd, that fish is kind of tired, I think.
You think he's tired?
I think he was cartwheeling in.
He was cartwheeling in. He's got to be dizzy.
He's got to be dizzy because he's spinning around right now. And tell you what, we're kind of tired too. We've been fishing here all morning, having a great time out here with Marshman Mass on. And I got to thank you for a great morning, buddy. We start off with speckled trout and then go in the marsh, catch some bass. Down here, you can launch anywhere you want in the Chalmette area, Shell Beach, all of these areas. You can get back in these marsh, catch these fish, go in the ship channel, catch the speckled trout. It's a lot of fun. And we hope you enjoyed the show today. Check out Todd, Marshman Masson on YouTube. Subscribe to your channel, correct?
Yeah, no doubt, subscribe. Channel's booming, lots and lots of great stuff on there, all based here in South Louisiana.
It all is, just like we are on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV, and we hope to see you next time. For producer Joey Bordelon and Todd Masson, or Marshman Masson, I'm Kevin Ford. Hope you enjoyed the show today. It's been a great morning. We're glad you were with us, and we'll see you next time right here on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.